Hello, my beautiful Capricorns. Welcome to your weekly love forecast horoscope for November 18th to 24th. I want to thank you guys so much for liking, sharing, and subscribing. And thank you to my members. I really appreciate all of your support. And if you guys would like a live personal reading with me, you can go to my website, jenniferwalkerzen.com, or check out the description box below. All right, let's change up camera views here. So we're going to be looking at your day-to-day, your love interest feelings, the blocks, delays, and challenges, and the overall outcome. And if you guys like it this way, you want me to continue this way, hit that like button. Let me know in the comments below. You can do both. Let's jump right in. All right. So what's up to my Capricorn romantic love life for November 18th to the 24th? Show me the cards I need, Tracy. Show me the cards I need. Two, sink. All right, let's take a look here, Capricorn. All right, so this is the 18th, this is the 19th. This is the 20th, this is 21st, this is the 22nd, this is the 23rd, this is the 24th. This is your love interest feelings, this is blocks, delays, and challenges, and the overall outcome. So if the day-to-day is confusing at all, just stick with me till the end. I'm going to go over your love interest, feelings, blocks, delays, and challenges, and the overall outcome. And if you guys like it this way, you want me to continue this way? Hit that like button. Let me know in the comments below. Okay, Capricorn, somebody is really desiring you, obsessing here, right? There's this strong attachment here with the Devil card energy coming out. Let's see what the blockage is here. So the blockage is thinking, contemplating, analyzing. Okay. All right, let's see what that's about. Planning. All right. Maybe not taking so much of an action, but keep thinking about something. Okay, so let's see how this is going to play out for the week here. So there's a lot of soul searching going on here with the Hermit card energy on the 18th of November, right? It's like I've discovered something. I figured something out. I realized something here, right? There's this soul searching going on. This very deep soul searching going on here with the Hermit card energy. Let's keep going. My Capricorn's romantic love life for November 18th to 24th. Show me the cards I need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. So someone's like, I want to come home. Someone wants to come home. There's a shock and surprise. There's a shock and surprise. Wow, so you guys are going to get this big shock and surprise, and you're going to be thinking about this situation very deeply. Let's see what else I pick up on. Someone wants to shatter something, break free from a situation that they've been feel stuck in. Okay, so let's see more information about what that's about. Okay. So far, what do we got? We got this deep soul searching going on. What's going to happen, my Capricorns? Romantic love life, November 18th to 24th. Show me the cards I need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. Okay, let's see. So there's some soul searching going on about some self-doubt or some infringing party here that caused a massive change in the situation. Okay, so let's keep going here. All right, so let's keep going. And then you always go by omens too. So we hear that there's a siren. Sirens represents emergency, something urgent. So there was something urgent about the situation. So it's gonna have my Capricorn romance of love life November 18th to 24th, and there it comes. Show me cards I need to see, a real strong emergency. Show me the cards I need to see, show me the cards I need to see. Okay. Okay, this has to do with starting a family. It's like co-creation. And we see shock and surprised about some kind of self-doubt or infringing party. And you finding out something, discovering something, really, it's like almost like the self-reflection causes this huge breakthrough about this situation. All right, let's see what's going on the 19th here. So there's a person that is concerned, Capricorn, that they offer you something and you may not accept it, that you may be bored with the situation or you just aren't interested, okay? Because it looks like they're going to try to reach out to you. We see this letter message document. This person is feeling like isolated, separated. They've been doing a lot of soul searching. Now, that isn't your energy right here. This is your. This could be your person. So take it as it resonates. Okay. So we see there's people involved in the situation or wanting to spend some time together. Okay. Let's keep going. Okay. Yeah, Three of Cups is the celebration card, hanging out with friends, having a good time here on the 19th. All right, let's see what that's about. With a Gypsy, when you see the child card energy, it can represent starting a family. It can talk about fresh start, new opportunity. Okay, naivete. Okay. There's an abundance of energy coming towards you in messages. Okay. So something about this situation this week seems to be so far about somebody who wanted to either blend families together, start a family, and we see something about this, or maybe even, okay, so it's not that. I know some of you guys are going to come at me in the comments saying, okay, that's not my situation. It also could be, you know how when you are involved in a love situation, sometimes you start like projects or endeavors with that person. So it's like something about some kind of co-creation, some kind of working together to do something, whether that be a family or that could be maybe even some kind of business endeavor with this person. But we see that there are the sense of let's hang out, let's spend some time together, let's reconnect, okay? I want to just really be in your physical presence. And you're getting communication about this, okay? So wow, that's definitely an omen. There was a motorcycle outside, okay? And the Knight of Wands for me is the motorcycle. So it's also, I've noticed with the Knight of Wands, it can also represent a vehicle or a fast moving vehicle. But it's for this case scenario on the 21st, it looks like there could be some passionate stuff going on here. Okay, passionate exercises here with the Knight of Wands energy. And it also looks like if that's not the case for some of you guys, it could be the fact that somebody is going to act very fast and impulsive. Okay, so yeah, with the main person. Mm-hmm. Okay. And because somebody wants to stop something, break apart, or is concerned of a breakup. Okay. Because you have their heart right here. Actually, let's make sure we pull the right cards there. Because they want to mend and fix this situation. But everything happens for a reason. So far I can see this person's like, I want to start a family with you. I want to work together on this. Okay, I want to build something here. I want to blend families together. I want to do this project with you. You know, I want to spend time with you. I want to talk with you about this. And I want to try to fix this situation, mend the situation between me and you. It's almost like you found out, Capricorn, that the reason why this person wanted to do this project was because it was influenced by a person who didn't have good intentions. That's what I feel like. It's like through this soul searching, through this breakthrough you have about this situation, it was like there was some kind of self-doubt about it, or you were, so if it isn't a particular person, it could be saying you had some self-doubt about the situation and then you really thought about it and something is coming to light and it really changes something with this situation with this person. Okay. So King of Pentacles, definitely your person is like, I want to be with you in the long term. And also Pentacles have to do with money, family, children, long term, something solid here. But there's like this cautious and defensive energy. But it's like, I feel really happy and joyful. And it's time, Capricorn. It's like the timing is right. Okay, let's layer another. Let's just layer these cards. Since these cards want to keep wanting to go on to the reading, let's just layer them on. All right, what's going to have my Capricorn's romantic love life, November 18th to 24th? Show me cards you need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. All right, so there's been this patient energy. This person can't stop thinking about you. There is a want to be with you, Nine of Cups energy. And we see there's some jealousy going on here. And it's like, you have all the tools I need, Capricorn. You're everything that I wanted, okay? Everything that I need. You're my ideal partner. I want to speak with you and talk with you about this. I want to help you with this situation, or I felt like I was being used to give you a sense of direction or to put us on the right path. We see something about travel, movement, moving in the right direction. There's a sense of heartache and sadness. I feel sad, I've been crying, I've been upset, heartbroken about you. I want to give this some time. I want to invest time. I want to see what happens with this Seven of Pentacles energy. I want to go after what I want here, because I'm ready to put the effort into this connection, Capricorn. I feel like you're a blessing to me in my life. But I feel like something about the situation makes me feel trapped, or like my hands are tied. Okay, so let's bring it all together. So this person's like been waiting around, trying to be patient. They keep thinking about you. There is a real want for you, right? We have this Nine of Cups energy. There is some jealousy here, okay? And we see that because Capricorn, they're like realizing you're their person, okay? They're heartbroken and sad. They feel trapped. They feel like their hands are tied. Like there's nothing they can do about it until you make that decision. And we literally had at the bottom of the deck, right? The Devil card energy. I cannot stop thinking about you, morning, noon, and night, that kind of energy. So it's like, I want to start this family. You know, I want to spend time together. There's communication coming in. I want to fix and mend this situation. It's time, right? I want to do this traveling here, or I want to move in the right direction because this is a blessing to me. There's a shock and surprise about this single and available to pursue, or the sense of independence or soul searching going on. Because of the abundance of breakup or walking away, and we see that this sense of happiness and joyful energy comes in because there's a sense of direction now. And I really want to pull my weight. I want to put the effort into this. So it seems like this person that you were dealing with, they didn't want to pull their weight. They didn't really want to put effort into the connection before. But now they're like, I want to put effort into this connection. And they're letting you know that something had happened with this infringing party or this person that had caused some issues here. We see letter, message, or document. We see something about child, okay, fresh start, new opportunity. Also, there could be concern because of an infringing party or jealousy about that infringing party. And we see main person is saying, I'm very cautious and defensive. I don't want to be used here, and I want to go after what I want. So, and they're wanting you. They want to be your main person. This person wants to be your main person. And they're being very protective of you when it comes to other people, okay? So we see what signs are involved in the situation. Aries, Sagittarius, Leo energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. So three people are standing out. Three energies are standing out in this situation, okay? So we see, I've been deeply thinking about this. I'm concerned that what I offer you won't accept. We see this friendship, celebration, going out, having a good time. And we see this passionate action taking place. But I want to make the wisest decision on the long term. I want to talk with you about it. I want this to be an investment of time. I want to see what happens with this, with the Seven of Pentacles energy. Okay, so Capricorn, let's take a look at with this cipher. How's your love interest feel about you? Your love interest feels like you are independent, you know? Your love interest feels like there's a deep love for you, Ace of Cups energy. Your love interest feels like you're very giving and charitable with the Six of Pentacles energy. And I do get the sense that sometimes they feel like you give too much to others. Your love interest feels that you fulfill their desires, and your love interest is wanting to do something from before, looking back to the past, looking at old memories of the past here with you. Your love interest, going further here, your love interest wants to surprise you, wants to give you something of value, maybe even a gift, because they feel like there's something more spiritual or divine about you or this connection. Your love interest loves you, Ace of Cups energy. Your love interest wants to go the distance. Your love interest wants to focus on this brand new life, this new beginning. Your love interest wants to do some traveling with you towards a sense of happiness, and your love interest wants, they want something legal here. Okay, so they want to make it legal, official, okay? Or they want you to make some kind of decision. Okay. And they also may want you to be single and available to pursue, because if the Six of Pentacles is showing, sometimes the Six of Pentacles can show that somebody feels like there's not an equal give and take, but they want you for sure. Like, you see that Nine of Cups, you fulfill their desires. All right, so let's see what the blockage is. Let's come back to the blockage here. Four of Swords. So lots of thinking, contemplating, analyzing, overanalyzing. Well, it is divine timing. We see the Fates card. But it's like, I need to have a strategy here. I need to be strategic about this. Okay. Because of stuff that happened before when it came to this house and family situation. Okay, so it's like a lot about what happened before, and it's like I need to analyze this. I need to think about this. I'm not sure. Is it really fated? Is it really the time? So a lot of overthinking, planning. Okay, so let's see what the overall energy is here. Queen of Pentacles, Seven of Wands, Star card energy. I'm going to lay everything out and then just see what else my intuition picks up on here. All right, we got the Emperor card, or the Lord card energy. You see Person card. And we see the Attention card, okay. We see this Gift card energy, Mirror card, okay. And if I go further on this, we see the Anxiousness, Moon, Temple card, okay. We see that Peace card. Okay, let's look at it as a whole now, okay. So we see there could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy giving some advice. It looks like there's somebody here and it's like, I want to defend my position against these other people because I have the higher ground here. Because we're spiritually connected, there's spiritual signs, there's synergies here in this connection. And it's also very motherly energy here too. As I told you, something about starting a family or children, building families together, something along those lines, okay? So someone feels really anxious. They're trying to listen to their intuition and they feel like there's this spiritual path, this destiny to this connection. We see that there's a want to gain control over this, and someone's trying to help with the situation, and it does look like you guys are getting a lot of attention, right? You are getting a lot of attention. And also that could also be the concerning thing, because there may be a sense of competition there. Someone feels like they're competing with someone else. We see that there's this really happy surprise or gift here, because someone feels bad about what happened. They're regretful about what happened, and they're concerned about losing out, because we saw that there was this concern about missing some type of opportunity here. So it's like, I want to bring peace to the situation. There's two opportunities that have opened up, and it looks like you have to make a decision here with your heart. And it looks like someone's really trying to force the issue, wants to move forward, take a risk, and they've come to the edge. They're gonna go for it, okay? So with your situation, I feel like there's one particular person that feels like there's a really divine connection. This may have been a person that either you thought about starting a family with, or something around that situation, okay? Or motherly energy here is trying to give some kind of advice, and it's like, I need to defend my position for this. I see something hopeful here. I want to gain control over this situation. You know, I want to help you with this. And you have this attention being put on you. There's this happy surprise, and there's something about from before that caused some kind of regrets and a loss. So it's like, I don't want to lose out on this situation because I know there's something more about this connection. Okay, does that make sense, Capricorn? Because there is a sense that I can have long-term happiness here. And there's this shock and surprise about this because it's this huge spiritual breakthrough. And it looks like there's a movement towards a traditional relationship. We see a marriage card coming out. And it looks like you get clarity this week about good news or potential for love, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. And we see that there's actions of love being taken here. So we see this party, this celebration. We see something about money and finance here, and we see something about money and finance involving this house, home, family situation. And it's like, my hands are tied, but I want to be with you, and I don't want to be foolish about this. So it's like some complexities around this, okay? Some complexities around this. We see this travel here for romance, and we see this could be somebody you had, there could be a friend involved with this as well. So I see there's two situations going on here. Okay, for some of you Capricorns. All right, there is this situation where there's a friend, and then there's a situation where somebody that you either thought about starting a family with, seeing them as a long-term happiness, or at one time you did, and there started to be some signs around this situation for you. Okay, so we see worries and concern. We see someone's following intuition. There's concerns about somebody walking away, and there's concerns about barriers or challenges because of indecisions. So it's like there's a choice that needs to be made here. Okay. We see that there is this very caring connection, and we see that the doors of romance have opened up. And we see this person could be far away, or some travel involved with the situation, or could be a foreign element to this. We see, I love you. They're opening up, sharing their feelings, and talking about the regrets of what happened. And there's concern about, I don't want to keep going around and round in circles with you. Right? I don't want to keep repeating the same thing, Capricorn. I'm ready for something more. You know that we're divinely connected. Okay, so someone's opening up, you're getting clarity, you're getting a better understanding of the situation, and you are seeing the truth around this situation. Okay. Okay. Which makes sense, because if you follow the Vedic, technically Rahu is in Pisces. Pisces represents past stuff and stuff that's hidden that can now, it's shining a flashlight on it. So it does make sense what's going on here. Okay. Let me get you guys some advice. What's going to happen in Capricorn's romantic love life for November 18th to 24th? Show me cards you need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. And someone had asked in the comments, and I'll answer this right now since I'm thinking about it. Someone asked in the comments, how can so many people have so many similar things happen to them? It's because of astrology. It's because we... tarot readers, palm readers, it's all astrology. We're all drawing upon that astrology. It's just we're not using software for it. Okay, so communication will be the key. You're gonna have to work through your fears here, Capricorn, and have faith in your dreams. Emotionally, nothing is set in stone, but you're gonna have to step out of your comfort zone, because this may make you feel uncomfortable, right? This may be an unusual situation. Adjustments will have to be made here, but your hard work will pay off. Just believe that it's possible. What you thought was impossible is now possible, Capricorn. So don't let the past hold you back. It's showing me that what you think the worst thing could be, it's not. You're good enough. That you do have to ask yourself, what do you have to release here? You're ending a tough cycle now. Take a breath here and meditate and contemplate about what you want. All right, my beautiful Capricorns. I love you guys so much. If you guys like it this way, you want me to continue this way, hit that like button. Let me know in the comments below. You know I love to hear from you guys in the comments below. So if this resonates, you want to claim this message, or you feel comfortable sharing your own personal situation with me, Capricorn, I would love to hear from you guys in the comments below. I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys soon.